I've used Adobe Lightroom for years, but can I move my stock photography workflow from Adobe Lightroom into DXO PhotoLab 9? Join me today to find out. So stock photography is a fairly simple workflow. I've been submitting to stock agencies for 20 odd years, starting off with Alamy, and then I started moving to the micro stocks, and now I've completely abandoned the micro stocks and stick solely with Alamy. It's a relatively simple workflow, but it does require consistency. And particularly with Alamy, you need to be very, very consistent with your quality control. If you fail one of your quality control criteria during submission, you get knocked down. If your star rating drops down, then your submissions take longer to go through. They're more closely scrutinized. Now, I'm pleased to say I've got a 3-star rating with Alamy. My submissions have been very, very consistent. And I want to make sure that if I move my workflow over to DXO PhotoLab 9, that I can maintain that consistency. Now, the things that they really look at in submission is, first of all, the sharpness. It needs to be sharpness. If there's any blurriness, sometimes even motion blur, they will disregard it if they think it's unintentional motion blur. But generally, sharpness needs to be spot on. Noise is also a major issue, so you need to check that the noise is controlled and run noise reduction if required. Also, they're very, very particular on dust and dirt. If you've got dust bunnies or other sorts of blemishes on your image, you need to clone those out and get rid of them. It can be an absolute nightmare if you've got a dirty sensor, but it does need to be done. And then, of course, there's the regular things like exposure, contrast and colour. They need to be pretty much spot on. What you're looking to give your stock agency is a striking looking image, technically perfect, one that's going to stand out in a sea of other images and entice an image buyer into commissioning it. So today we're going to have a look at transferring my Adobe Lightroom workflow over to DXO PhotoLab 9 and just see how it transfers. I suspect it will be relatively easy, but we're going to have a deeper look at that. And if you've been following me, you'll know that I'm on a bit of a journey with DXO PhotoLab and comparing it very much to what I do in Adobe Lightroom. And as such, I do have a 15% discount on DXO products, and I'll leave a link for that in the description below. So without any further ado, let's jump into DXO PhotoLab. We'll have a look at some images that I took earlier in the week with my new DJI Air 3S drone of the Penshaw Monument in the snow. It was a bit of a grey old day, but the images look relatively clean and tidy. And we'll see if we can find some stock suitable images and prepare them for stock and output them. So let's get into it. So when I import my images, I always import them externally to Lightroom, and I always have done. This has allowed me to be able to move to a different editing software, such as DXO PhotoLab 9. And as you can see here, I've got them split into various years. So I've got 1994 to 2006, 2007, 2012, and so on. And my current one is 2021 to date. And if I open that, I have all the images sorted by year, and then if I go into 2006, you'll see that I have them by month and then by date and location. And this is the shoot that I did on Monday with the new DJI Air 3S drone, and I'll leave a link to my first impressions video on that again in the description below. And these are all the images here. I shot JPEG and in RAW DNG. I always do that just so I've got a backup, and you can see all the images are here. So let's go over to DXO PhotoLab. We'll close that down. And as you can see, I have basically a copy of my Finder here on the left-hand side of the screen. This is my main photo drive. And as we can see, there are the folders that we just previously looked at. And here's the folder of the images that I took on Monday. And here we can see them all. And we can scroll through them and just have a look that everything's imported and looks okay, which it does. As I mentioned in my first video, you can drag the top down like this so you can get a better preview of the image, which is a very, very handy thing to do. and a quick double click will allow you to zoom in and check focus and noise and stuff like that. This is one of the early images. It was still quite dark, but it was shot at ISO 140. And as you can see, it's fairly clean and it's fairly sharp. Now, if I pull that back up, in Lightroom, my simple procedure is to give a star rating. And the way I do that is to press either the numlock keys or the keys at the top of the keyboard. And I can rate them 3, 4, or 5, or I can give them an X if I want to delete them. For me, a 3-star image is one that can be submitted to stock. A 4-star image is one that can be definitely kept and looked at for use in other things, maybe printing. And a 5-star image is a definite portfolio potential image. And in PhotoLab 9, we do have that star rating and it does work with the keyboard. So if I just select this one, I can give it a 3-star rating, or give it a 0 rating, or a 4-star rating, or a 5-star rating. But let's just have a little look through these images. We'll drag this top down and we will scan through and just see if any of them are worthy of stock. Now, this image here, I think, might be worthy of stock. It was taken with the telephoto lens on the DJI Air 3S in low light, so it might be quite noisy. And this is also the JPEG version. So we'll go back to the DNG version, the RAW version. Yes, and as you can see, that is pretty noisy, but I think with the modern noise reduction, we can get rid of that noise, and that might be worthy for a stock image. So we'll give that a 3-star rating, and we'll just have a little look through some of the others. And this looks potentially nice as well. We've got the sun rising up over the top right there. As you can see, I do bracket these images, so we'll find one that's got the histogram pretty much in the middle. We've got perhaps a little bit of clipping in that one, but that one looks pretty good. We'll give that a 3-star rating as well. And we'll just continue and have a little look through. There's not an awful lot of images here that are particularly worthy of stock, mainly because the weather wasn't particularly fantastic. This one looks very nice though. We've got some definition in the sky, the sun coming up, some colour. If we zoom in on it, we can check for noise and sharpness. It's certainly sharp enough, I think, and there is a little bit of noise. It was shot at only 120 ISO, so it should be okay and it will certainly clean up nicely, and I'm sure we can edit that into something nice. So we'll give that a 4-star rating. And let's just scroll down. And these images here look really nice as well, just as the sun's coming up in the background there. We've got some blue skies, we've got some colour in the skies. If we go to the DNG version, I think we'll give that a 3-star rating as well. So that's probably enough for the selection. If we go over to the customize menu now, this is where we can actually edit the images. And what we're going to do is come down to the bottom left here and we're going to filter out 3-star images and 4-star images. And unlike in Lightroom, what you actually have to do, if you want to select 3-star, 4-star and 5-star, you will actually need to hold the control button down as well. So here I've got 3 and 4-star, and I can also select 5-star as well. I don't think we actually selected any 5-stars, but there we go. We've got the images that we've selected for stock there. Now I'm only going to work on one of these images, and I think it will be this one that we actually have up on screen. And this first thing again is we just go in and we check for noise and sharpness, and that's absolutely fine. We also need to check for dust. Now there won't be any dust on this image because it's from a drone image. It's a sealed camera. You don't get dust on the sensors, so there's not really any need to look for the dust. Noise levels are well controlled, and that all looks really fine. So the first thing we do is we go to the basics tab and we just get the basic exposure right. And I'm going to bring the overall exposure down a little bit. So we will come up here and we will just drag exposure down a little bit. That looks good. We've got a bit more definition in the sky. Now I think we bring the mid-tones up, which will give us back that definition down here. And then we'll just boost the contrast by bringing the blacks to the edge and the whites, the highlights, to the right of the image as well. And that's, I think the Penshaw monument down here looks very, very dark. So I think we'll actually bring the shadow areas up as well, just to make that punch out. Now, we can also experiment with some of the smart lighting systems that DXO provide us. So let's try the DXO smart lighting, see if that makes any difference. Not a great difference. We'll switch that off and then we'll have a look at ClearView. Now that's added some nice definition to the sky. And if we combine that with smart lighting, how does that work? Yeah, that looks really good. So we've got a bit of extra definition in the sky there. So we've got a decent looking image. It's reasonably contrasty. It's got some colour. And I think we might just punch that sky out using the AI masking tools. So we're going to load AI masking tools. And we're going to select the AI mask here, and we're going to select the sky area simply by just dragging over the sky. And that looks pretty good. Now, we're not going to go mad with this. We're just probably going to bring the midtones down a little bit. And we're going to add a little bit of micro contrast, which I think is very much like dehaze, and perhaps just boost the saturation a little bit. And now we will close that out and that will bake those adjustments in. And because we've made those adjustments on a relatively small sensor, it's prudent to go in and just check for noise. And we'll just wait for that. There is definitely some noise out in that shadow areas of the background there. And if we come down to the monument here, it doesn't look too bad there. So we'll come back out to the basic tools. And as you can see at the moment, it's on the standard instant render noise reduction. That's the lowest level. So we'll click it on XD2S noise reduction and see how that looks. We'll zoom in first so we can get a good idea of how it works. And then we'll just click on that and just wait for it to pop in. And yeah, that's definitely made a bit of a difference. I'm going to actually increase the Luma noise reduction a little bit. And yeah, that looks really, really nice. That's a really nice image. Now, one of the things that is well worth doing when you're submitting images to stock is actually adding your metadata into the images before you export them. Now, I'll just quickly show you how you can do that in PhotoLab DX9. And you go back to the Photo Library module, select the image that you wish to add the keywords to, and you can literally cut and paste your keywords in here. And you can also, importantly, add your headline description, categories, and stuff like that. Now, I think Alamy will pick up the headline as the title and then the description as a longer form caption, and then it will also add the keywords. So I'm not going to do that right now, but that metadata dialogue is very easy to understand, and that metadata will be exported. Now, to export the images, I will filter down again to the 3, 4, and 5-star images. And then if I go Control A to select all of them, and then I can right click and go to export, very, very similar to Lightroom, and we'll go to export to disk, and that will open up the export to disk options. Now, as you can see, I've actually put in an Alamy export preset here, and I really like this export dialogue. It's very, very easy to understand, very, very easy to adjust. And for my export to Alamy, I export as JPEG. I have it at 95% quality. I have a specific folder that it goes to called stock exports. I don't do any batch renaming. I don't resize anything. I send it out as it is cropped or not cropped. No watermarks, obviously. And I send it out as an sRGB. Now, that might seem counterintuitive. Alamy actually sends images out to their clients as sRGB. So there's really no benefit in using an Adobe RGB because it will just be sent out as sRGB anyway. And then metadata, obviously, you include all that will send out your caption, description and keywords and embed them in to the image when you send it out. Now, a really nice thing, as well as the fact that it's actually easy to set up presets, you can actually set two presets at the same time and it will send them out in different locations and different file types simultaneously, which is a really, really nice thing to have. I'm not going to export these now because they aren't actually ready prepared for stock. I will work on these images a little later in the week. I'll cancel that for now. So I really hope you've enjoyed that look at my new workflow in DXO PhotoLab 9 for stock photography. To be quite honest, it was broadly very similar to the Lightroom version. There was very, very few differences. The major difference was the need to press Control to select multiple star ratings to filter out. As I mentioned at the beginning of the screencast, I use 3, 4, and 5-star ratings, and all of those would go to stock. So you need to press Control and then the 3 and 4 and 5 stars to select all of them. It is a slight difference, but certainly not noticeable. You still have the color ratings that I use in Lightroom, where I have red to say it's ready to be submitted and green to say it has been submitted. So that's all very, very similar. So, and obviously adding the metadata is just as simple as it is in Lightroom. One thing I really did like is on the export dialog, it's much cleaner, much easier to understand than Lightroom's. And also the fact that you can pick multiple presets and output your images in two different formats, perhaps JPEG and perhaps TIFFs, whatever your needs are. That's a really useful feature to have, and I was quite impressed by that. So overall, it's been very, very easy to adapt my workflow into DXO PhotoLab 9. As I mentioned at the beginning of the video, I do have a 15% discount code if you're interested in trying out PhotoLab. I've been very, very impressed with it so far. Of all the alternatives to Lightroom that are on the market, I found this one the most easy to adapt to. And I think a lot of that is because of its broad similarities to Lightroom, that's made that transition to a different editing software much, much easier. So I hope you've enjoyed this video. If you have, a like would be fantastic. A subscription would be even better. And I really look forward to seeing you in the next one.